We are incredibly excited to partner with Medical University of South Carolina on their new program in our DNA SC and really enable all participants and patients throughout South Carolina to access precision population health to improve the health of themselves, but also their families.
Clearly, from an MUSC perspective, we want to be leaders in precision health and precision medicine, and we identified that we had some gaps in that space that we wanted to fill. And one thing that was really important to us was launching a statewide population genomics program at no cost to South Carolinians so that we could begin to help empower them with information to take more proactive approaches to their health.
Maybe the long-run view on Helix is that we certainly believe that genomics is going to be standard of care over time. And so partnering with leading health systems who are really exploring the use of that data in all the ways we can improve patient care is clearly one of our key focuses.
What we're excited about with Helix is they're a CLIA-certified lab. So anything that's done at a research level, if it's got a clinical validation and a clinical use, we can issue a clinical report and have immediate benefits for our patients and participants.
The second piece on the clinical results and the reason why we think it's essential to return clinical data back is when we did the study in Renown in something like the first 30,000 people, we saw that the prevalence rate was roughly 1 in 75 people with carriers of a pathogenic mutation and say BRCA1, BRCA2 Lynch or familial hypercholesterolemia, so the CDC tier 1. But I think the most stunning thing was about 90% of them would have been missed in typical practice. So there is no other way to really identify them because most people will not know of their family history so that you can't actually use that to help screen them or that data is not appropriately captured. And so just having this ability to really drive important clinical findings for patients so they can get the right preventative care is, I think, really important here.
And I think from an MUSC perspective, it was insufficient for us to think about this as just a regional or Charleston-based initiative because we want to make sure that the patients who participate in the program are reflective of our overall population. And we have, you know, a significant African-American population, for instance, in South Carolina that has been historically excluded from a lot of opportunities to better understand their health. So for us, it was a no-brainer that it would be statewide for those two reasons.
Yeah, I mean, let me take the 10,000-foot level of it, which is, you know, in healthcare, our belief is that genomic data, the data you the genome you inherit is the only data set in healthcare that doesn't change with time. So if you generate a high enough quality data set, you should be able to use that data again and again, both in the clinical setting, but also in the research setting. And so we're very focused on delivering that mission because it allows both from a clinical perspective speed to answer, but also a dramatic reduction in cost because digital queries always cost less than chemistry. And so that's kind of our philosophy. And so we're very focused on both enabling those clinical workflows as well as the research aspect of that so we can drive new discoveries back into the clinic over time.